Gautam, I see from your hobby, you listen to Hindi songs.
Yes, sir.
Which songs of Hindi?
So usually from the film industry.
Huh?
So usually from the films, from the Hindi films. So they could either be old songs or also from...
Old songs from where?
So old songs as well as Hindi songs.
From?
From the Indian Hindi films.
Hindi films. Yes. Listen to Hindi film songs.
Yes.
What's the difference between the old songs and the new songs?
So I think in the newer songs there is more focus on the beats. I mean they are more inclined towards being at a faster pace compared to the older songs. And probably the nature of the lyrics have also changed. In the older times there was more emphasis on the lyrics. Now it's shifted towards beats and music.
Old songs are mostly based upon classical ragas, isn't it? That's the main thing, old songs. Before 70, it was from 1950 to 70, they were all based upon, most of them are from classical ragas. Now, all beats and rhythm. Okay, okay. Have you heard of National Population Register?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
So it is a database of all the residents that are living in the country, and that would include anyone who has been living for the past.
Be louder.
The data set would include everyone who has been living in the country for the past 6 months, or who is willing to live in the country in the coming 6 months.
The National Population Register.
Yes.
Okay. Why has Kerala gone to the Supreme Court under Article 131 and many other now in the Jharkhand or some other states they have gone to
Punjab has also.
Punjab. Many around 10 of them are opposing and some of them have already gone. So why they are going under Article 131?
So in the Article 131 Supreme Court has the original and the exclusive jurisdiction with respect to any contract between the state and the union. So with regard to that, the states who are not favoring the union government's move of CA, that is Citizenship Amendment Act, so to oppose that, they have moved to Supreme Court.
But why they have gone? They should say we will not work on that. They can say why they have gone to Supreme Court under Article 131. The original jurisdiction between the center and states and between states, center and one state on to one side and state or state on the other, three kind of disputes. So, why have they gone? They should not have gone because they are supreme in their jurisdiction. They will not do it.
The citizenship is on the union list and the parliament is empowered to make law on that particular subject. And under article, I'm not able to recall the exact article, but the states are compelled to, they are duty bound under the constitution to implement that act. So they don't have exclusive sovereignty over implementing that act.
Is it 256? Sorry. Article?
So I think it should be 365.
If a center gives a direction can be given regarding what? The central government can give a direction on what matters?
So if a law is made
The legislative powers are distributed as per Schedule 7, Union List, State List and Concurrent List. Okay. So, under what power the central government will give a direction to the states?
So, the executive power of the Union, it is overpowering over the states.
The executive powers are coextensive with the legislative powers. Only in those matters it can give directions. Law and order they cannot give. Yes. Law and order is state subject.
Yes.
So if they do not obey, if the state doesn't obey, then what will happen?
So there could be a claim of breakdown of constitutional machinery in the state.
What?
There could be a case of breakdown of constitutional machinery in the state. So
the administration cannot be carried on in accordance with the constitution.
Yes.
Which article?
So I'm confused between Article 356 and Article 365.
It is 365. 356 says that when the governor or president is of the opinion that it cannot be carried on, then it will be imposed. But 365 says in which situation it will be legitimate, legal for the president to hold that the government of the state cannot be carried on in accordance with the constitution. That is the only example. When the center gives a direction, executive direction, then if they do not obey, it will be legal for the president to hold that the administration of the state cannot be carried on in accordance with the constitution. So this Article 56 picks up and the state government can be dismissed. Okay. These are the articles you should blossom. Okay. Please. Right.
Well, Gautam, you are from Haridwar.
Yes, sir.
What is the significance of Haridwar?
Firstly, it has religious significance for Hinduism. There is organization of Kumbh Mela. It is one of the four cities where Kumbh Mela is organized. And secondly, it has got from the point of view of the economy, it has got a lot of tourism potential. So that is another significance. That is the another significance from the economic point of view. But I think majorly it is the religious angle.
What exactly Haridwar means? The word Haridwar has got significance. What does it mean?
Say if we break it down, it's Haridwar. So Har means Shiva, and Dwar is gateway. So,
and it is a gateway to something. Where? Gateway to some river. Actually, from the hills in Haridwar only the Ganges flows from the foothills. So until then it is all along the hills it moves, you know. So that's why Haridwar is the Haridwar and the Rishikesh. Then that is where it grows in a almost plain. And from there, of course, it flows. So that is the entrance of Haridwar. Haridwar is the place where Dwar is entrance. So that is how it is there. It is the entrance to the where the Ganges reaches the plains. Okay, so it is well. You have been born in Bareilly.
Yes, sir, but I've never lived there. Sir.
Yeah?
I've never lived there.
You have never lived there, but your parents were there.
My maternal grandparents were
grandparents
there.
Grandparents are there. So you know anything about Bareilly?
No, sir.
Anyway, I think you should pick up something about Bareilly. Bareilly is an important railway station in Northern Railway.
Okay, sir.
Besides that, what are the other important things in Bareilly also you should know? Your father is working in a public sector as a general manager. No, which public sector?
ONGC.
And you have got ONGC Videsh now. What is the role of ONGC Videsh?
It is for securing the interests, the energy interests of the country in foreign countries.
What do they do?
So they are related with drilling and research, finding out the oil and gas exploration purposes in foreign countries in collaboration with foreign countries in foreign territories.
There was an issue in Vietnam with the ONGC Videsh. I don't know whether you are aware of that. I think, ONGC Videsh can go and also not only find oil wealth there, but they can also do operation. It's, of course, they are, as per the law of that particular country. ONGC Videsh is the arm of ONGC performing outside the country. So that's something about that also, you know, if you ONGC and ONGC, because your father is working there, you have indicated as DM in public sector undertaking, so the question can come on that. You had been in Dart Weiss German fellowship, some scholarship. What is it? You explain about that.
So it is a program for undergraduate.
It is DART. DAAT. What does it mean?
It is in German.
I know. What is it?
Sir, I don't. I can't recall the exact German words, but in the English translation
is. You should know, because when you have been. When you have mentioned here Dad Wise Scholarship, what Dad acronym stands for? See, just like GIZ. So, DAD is also an acronym for that particular, I don't know what is the scholarship. Some Deutsch, it must be something with Deutsch. Deutsch is German.
Yes.
So what is that scholarship? You just know this. Huh? And what did you do in that? That exchange program for summer, what exactly you did? Did you do any project there?
Yes, sir, it was a research project.
What project did you do?
So it was a research project on ultra high performance one.
I think your voice is little low, I'm not able to hear. What project?
So it was a research project on ultra high performance. Ultra high performance concrete.
Okay, what exactly was the finding? So you just about this project, again 5 sentences or 10 sentences you write down. What exactly was objective? What exactly you arrived at the end? Maybe for 1 or 2 months, how many months you did?
2.5 months.
2.5 months. In the 2.5 months period, whatever you came out, what are the final this thing finding of this project?
So the final finding was that they were working on making the structures more leaner. So it was a part of that project, was on the entire project in search. But as per your
whatever new project you did as a part of the project, which must be the, see, like that your other friends must have been also doing something, or you were the only group doing?
So, I was the only person who was associated with the project.
So in that case, for the 2.5 months, what exactly you did and what was the result? You write down 5 or 10 sentences, you remember this. That also, what does it mean acronym? So that also you should write down. See, this is an advantage for you, because out of so many people you have been picked up. Because you had some merit on that, so that's why you have been picked up and you did this project. So you can impress the interview board by saying about what exactly you did. Even if they ask you about what is the DAD scholarship, immediately you can go up to the next question saying that, yeah, I have done this scholarship, I did that. In 1 or 2 sentences you can say. If they are interested, you can further explain to them. But this is how you can take interview board to your advantage. Where you are strong. But for that, you must be very clear about what you have done and write down that. And you have been in IIT tennis team also.
Yes, sir.
Huh? And you play in singles or doubles?
Both.
What do you think is your strong thing? Either the service is good or where you are strong?
I think my service is good.
Service is good, okay. Then of course, who are now the national champion in tennis? Who is the national champion now?
G. Prasanna. G. Prasanna and another.
The voice is going down, it is not audible to me. The voice is going down.
Very down. See, whenever your confidence level is high, your voice should come up. So, if you are taking the voice down, then it means your confidence level is low. So little more you have to practice on bringing the, because articulation is important. You have got good knowledge, but articulation is good, but your voice is low. The voice should impress the board. So that is tell what you were, so what he was asking you. Prasanna, you said then?
Yeah.
You were asking something.
No, I was telling that voice is going down.
So the who are the, see, in the national level tennis and international level, the latest one, Wimbledon, Australian Open, French Open, these things you brush up and then keep it. So if something is asked, immediately you should be able to answer.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Welcome, Goyal. So you are born on 1/11/1995.
Yes, sir.
The day before your birth, an important event took place in India. Sad development. What was it?
So in the year 1995.
You were born on 1/11/1995. Just a day before that, that is on 31/10/1995. Important event took place in modern India's history.
I'm sorry, sir, I'm not aware.
It was the assassination of the sitting Punjab Chief Minister, we are saying. It was one of the cut-off dates in Punjab in the crisis. 31/10/1995, he was killed in front of the Punjab Secretary, who was commanded by the dozen security generals. It was a car bomb. Your second choice is IFS.
Yes.
See, President Trump, almost a year back, has said that after the US leaving Afghanistan, India should take active part. That meaning of it is that we should, India should take military interest in Afghanistan, at least to the situation, till the situation gets normalized. Now, do you support Indian troops entering Afghanistan?
So far, the stand that India has taken with respect to Afghanistan has been that they have indulged in developmental aspect of it. Instead of sending troops in Afghanistan, they have rather chosen the path of training the Afghanistan troops to be capable enough. So India has taken the path of capability development in Afghanistan. So I think that stand is...
No, the question is straight. Do you support India sending its troops, armed troops, to Afghanistan to stabilize the situation once the US leaves Afghanistan? It's almost certain now they are going to leave in years by maximum. And India has got its own interest in Afghanistan. We have got our own investments. Do you support India sending its troops to Afghanistan? Say yes or no.
So as of now, I think India should not send its troops to Afghanistan. Because...
India has already sent troops to other countries for peacekeeping purposes and sometimes fighting with the armed rebels in their respective countries. So why not in Afghanistan?
So unless the government, the Afghanistan government requests India.
So if Afghanistan, new Afghan government or the sitting Afghan government invites India, we can send our troops. Are you sure? That's your stand?
Sorry, sir.
That is your stand, I'm asking.
So even in that situation, we should assess the geostrategic interests again and then we should take a call. But as of now, because there has not been any request...
So there is a basic difference between previous occasions when India has sent troops to various countries. And this time, if it sends its troops to Afghanistan, as per the invitations of the Afghanistan government, till that persists a basic difference. What is it? Do you understand what I am asking? It's simple. In other countries, yes, India has sent its troops to other countries. But under the aegis of the UN, under the leadership of the UN, here, we cannot send our troops just because Afghanistan is asking for India's help or something like that. They are not asked, that's a different story.
And our IPKF experience, you know,
sir, disaster.
Sorry,
IPKF.
Indian peacekeeping force in Sri Lanka. So you can always quote, sir, that the kind of thing is a disaster.
So what's stubble burning?
Stubble burning is an activity post the harvesting season. The agricultural.
It's recently in news for what?
So it is argued that the stubble burning is the major cause, one of the major causes for Delhi, for the poor air quality in Delhi.
Let me elaborate. It's connected with which case and what was Supreme Court's take on it and what was Punjab farmers' take on it?
So the Supreme Court has the Supreme Court has ordered that stubble burning should be stopped. But the difficulty in that is that the farmers, they claim that removing that stubble burning is the easiest way out because there is little time between harvesting and the growth of and the plantation of the new or the next crop. Stubble burning is the only solution that they find. But as another solution that the government has proposed is use of happy cedars, which could allow the plantation of the next crops even with the stubble in the field. So that could be a solution to end stubble burning.
See, you came from one of the prestigious institutions in the country, IIT Roorkee.
Yes, sir.
Why not even a single Indian university, including your IITs, the first 300 best universities of the world, in spite of spending crores and crores for your IITs, why not a single IIT was not able to get a place in first 300 universities of the world?
with respect to IITs, there is a scope of improvement in terms of IIT Roorkee. That I could say is that there has been an issue of shortage of faculty. Along with that, the issue of publications. These are the major parameters on which
the government spends lots of money.
Yes, sir.
And gives exemptions like reservations are not, you know, that much compulsory for institutions. And the vice versa, protective area. But still, you are not able to find out your place in first 300 universities, first 300. Is it because of the problems which is affecting the higher education in India, or it is something else?
So I think it is a combination of both the factors. Firstly, there are issues in the higher education sector. That would be there is public spending, but I think more can be done on that front. Along with that, there is also a lack of multidisciplinary research in the prestigious institutions, and with new technologies emerging, I think that need for multidisciplinary research is even more prominent right now. Along with that, another aspect is with the way the rankings are done. For example, one important aspect is whether the universities are open to foreign students or foreign faculty. So there is a restriction on that. Along with that, there is also an issue with foreign universities coming to India and promoting higher education sector there, because there is a limitation on that as well.
So can I take it like this? If government takes a policy decision of allowing foreign faculties into IITs, at least a couple of IITs will be in the world rankings. This is your position.
So with the scheme like Institute of Eminence, government is trying to nudge in that direction, and they have provided certain provision of certain percentage of students being from foreign countries or faculties being hired from the foreign institutes. So we'll have to see how that eventually reflects in the rankings in the universities.
Last question. What is this national quota of appeals? The concept of national quota of appeals.
I have not heard of it.
Okay.
You seem to be associated with sports. Much. Have you heard of this United by Emotions, the recent times? United by Emotions.
No, ma'am, I haven't.
So it is this theme of Olympics which is going to be held. So what role do you think emotion has in sports? We have the theme selected for this year's Olympics is that United by Emotion. So what does that denote? What is the role of emotion in sports?
I think by the theme United in Emotions, United by Emotions, what they're trying to highlight is that instead of creating the physical divisions that we have created, or maybe other social divisions that are there in the world as of now, that could be overcome if we use sports as a medium. And by emotions, it could be the emotion that's attached to the sports would be the urge to win, or the sportsmanship spirit that is associated with each sport, or that each sportsperson should have. So I think that is the emotion.
What are the three qualities as a sportsman you would bring into administration?
I think firstly would be to put in the effort, put in regular continuous effort, and along with a certain detachment from the result, because there is even in sport sometimes that you put in the effort but the result may not eventually come in your favor, but that doesn't mean that you stop going to the field next day. So I think that is one aspect that I would bring into it. Secondly, I think strategy would be an important part, because for each sport you need to have a strategy, and accordingly in administration also you need to have a strategy depending upon what the current situation is and what you imagine the situation should be, or what you want the situation to be like.
So you're preparing in Chennai? You are from Uttarakhand. How come you are in Chennai?
I'm currently undergoing training with RBI, the Reserve Bank of India.
Okay.
Great, Chennai.
You seem to be a very seem to be educated in IIT Roorkee, tennis, all these. You seem to be more technocrat. I don't feel a techno. How would a technocrat be suited for a general administration? What is the role of a technocrat in an administration? Talk for yourself.
I think my graduation, that is civil engineering. Well, engineering is in general about finding solutions to real life problem, and I think the major role of administrator is also to find solutions to the problems, find practical solutions to the real life problems. I think that is one aspect. And secondly, if I talk particularly about civil engineering, the administration has a lot of civil engineering works that are pursued, and I think my civil engineering background would help me better administer, better monitor those projects.
My last question would be, currently the Indian economy is facing a great slowdown. What do you think is the reasons for these slowdowns?
And the current reason, the current slowdown?
Slowdown in the economy. Is there a slowdown or economy is performing well?
And there is a slowdown.
Yeah. So what is the reason you feel?
And the reason could be attributed to both cyclical as well as structural factors. The structural aspect would be that for example, high logistics cost could be one of those factors which hinders our export.
Don't be very general, don't give me bookish answers. I'm asking you the very particular reasons for the current economic slowdown.
And it has been a poor demand in the markets.
You have to be more specific. Talk about the reforms, I mean the jolt, the reform measures which were initiated by the government which led to the current economic slowdown, starting at least from demonetization, GST, the demand slowdown, job loss. You have to talk about all that, which will, because all what you're talking is about the general term, general factors which you can pick out from the books. So you have to talk about all this jolt and reforms which has led to the current economic slowdown.
What is the specific significance of Roorkee in British history? So the Roorkee city as such was prominent with the construction of Upper Ganga Canal, and there is a Solony Aqueduct that is an important civil engineering feature.
What is my question?
How did Roorkee come into power? Importance of Roorkee. I'm sorry.
Okay. The question was, why was Roorkee formed during British
times?
Was it prominent
or not? So I recall its significance for two reasons. One is the Engineering Institute, and second is Bengal miners and sadhus, they had their establishment there.
Sapphires or is it
engineering? Bengal miners and sapphires were there, and then currently they have Bengal engineers group as having their establishment.
So you've been to Germany, and so what makes German engineering so special?
So German engineering is, particularly in the automobile sector, it is considered to be as a pioneer in that sector. And the reason I think is probably because of their educational setup. That
technology curriculum is almost globalized. It's same everywhere. Start with type of South Korea, the US, Asian countries, almost we all read the same. What is the difference there? What makes German engineering so unique in this world? What makes them so competitive?
So I think although I'm not sure of it, but one aspect could be that probably they have the option of specialization at an early stage in their academic curriculum. So that could be helpful in specialization and more make a person more inclined towards research and development.
A lot of those hobby industries in the open sector. The students, even when they are in college, they actually go and they start their own hobby industries. That's something which is very encouraged by private entrepreneurship in your study, something which is encouraged by the general USC. Very good to do your tax commission, article teams. Which university did you go?
Technical University in Munich.
Okay, in Munich. Do you know about the significance of Munich in World War?
It was a Munich conference, but I'm not sure about the details of it.
So, you had collected some funds for your college cultures, then sponsorship. So, how do you actually persuade some other students? How do you persuade them? What do they have to gain in order to, if they have to consider funding for your programs? Is there anything for them to gain? How do you actually persuade them?
So the way we tried to persuade them depended upon what field they were from or what sector that particular company was from. For example, if we are trying to pursue someone from a coaching industry, so our approach would be targeted towards the number of students who are coming. They could be...
So the coaching industry?
Yes, if we are trying to seek sponsorship from some coaching industry, from coaching institute, in that case we would pitch that we have people coming from different fields, from different colleges, so that could provide them exposure or advertisement in that regard. Secondly, if another way that we used to do it was through our alumni network. So that was another aspect. And thirdly, with again cater to the particular event. For example, if there is something that is related to adventure, then
well, of course you have collected money. That's why you get a sponsorship. But my question is, what do the companies gain by sponsoring? Is there anything the companies stand to gain? When I do some marketing, I intend to gain something out of it. What is the store for these companies? They sponsor, what do they gain? Coaching centers, is there anything that they have to gain? Because they sponsor some functions from schools, it's fine. College, there's nothing they have to gain because they already sent their students to the college system. What is there to gain out of these cultural institutes?
So even after, even for coaching centers, for example, even after college, there are different examinations that one can prepare. But in general, for the sponsors, I think one thing that it would gain was access to the students, the footfall that we received, which is significant. So I think one that could they could see that to be as a suitable.
Okay. So Rigo, what is a free pitch?
Free pitch.
So what is the pitch difference between needle compacting and plate compacting?
So with needle compacting, we have an instrument in the shape of a needle.
What is the difference? I know the process. What is the difference?
So needle compacting could be used in areas where we have an intricate network of reinforcement. So the accessibility of the compaction could be better improved with a needle compacting compared to a plate compacting. And moreover, plate compacting could be used where the surface is more uniform and more widespread. So it could provide more efficiency in that area.
Have you seen this instrument? Go on, let's see. What is its purpose?
So it is used in surveying, and it could be used to measure angles, vertical angles as well as the horizontal angles.
So, how is the overline different from a sextant? Have you heard of sextant?
Yes.
How is it different?
So I'm not able to recall that at all.
So do you have you watched tennis handicap?
I've heard of it.
You have seen a match. Why is that Germany is so good in football but not in tennis? Do you have any tennis players, prominent players from Germany?
Yes sir. Alexander is very good.
Okay. Compared to US, or for that matter of fact, UK. Those leagues, Germany does not fit in.
So I think one reason could be about the popularity of the sport, which in turn influences the population, influences the people to pursue a particular sport. And secondly, I'm not sure about the infrastructure that Germany has with respect to both the sports.
Yeah.
But because Germany has a better football team, I think the infrastructure for that particular sport would be better developed, and tennis might not have that well developed infrastructure in Germany. but I'm not sure about it.
So, can you tell me how to make tennis a four-man game? So, instead of a six-man game, so how can we make it a four-man game?
So firstly, it would be proper infrastructure that would require like coaching center, the tennis courts to be accessible and to be increased in number. That is lacking at present. That is why it continues to be a very
challenge. What about the cost? Is there any other solution? Out of the world, something new in the way to how we make that accessible.
Okay.
Just one last question. Can you explain ICSE? What is
ICSE? In concept for secondary education.
So, if I have to do homeschooling, the ICSE
syllabus,
is it possible to do?
So, you'll have a final board examination, you have to be given, will you be given a pass certificate?
Sorry, but from first standard to 10th class, I want to prepare my board, but I wait from the course content of the ICSE syllabus. Will I be allowed to take the examination or
not? So, there is provision of open board, but I'm not sure whether ICSE is allowed to.
Only CBSE,
ICSE. You're not allowed in ICSE.
You have to join an institution.
Only in matriculation and all they allow. If you have attained age, particular age, then you can appear directly as a private candidate.
In what syllabus?
Huh?
What syllabus?
In matriculation and.
Of course, matriculation, state board, CBSE is not allowed, but ICSE is not allowed.
They don't allow.
Okay. Still, since we are running short of time, I have got one observation. It seems you are not very happy about the interview.
I'm okay.
You are not interested in the interview. It should be more lively. Okay. But it doesn't look lively at all. Now only you are smiling. The whole interview,
you are not smiling at all.
You are very stern. Okay. And answer you give as if you are the main discussion maker. It's a group discussion. Somebody is asking questions, you should lead it and the whole team.
Okay.
So please practice it now. When is your interview?
So 23rd March.
Still 1 month is there. Practice this, make your voice more assertive. Okay.
I should smile more in the interview.
Huh?
I should smile more or
smile sometimes.
See, first of all, your voice, the tone slightly, you have to increase the volume. It's very low. To the extent, sometimes it is inaudible.
I'm so close and I find it hard to listen to you.
I'm mistaking it for humility or submissiveness, so something like that, your voice.
Ma'am, I usually speak like this. Maybe I'll work on it.
You just practice. Slightly louder. Because voice is very low being. See, whatever you answer, it should be audible to all the five.
And also try looking at all the board members, when you were answering, he was just looking at the person who suited that question only. So other members get bored and they start doing their own.
And it appears that you are a little tense. So be relaxed.
You are already in a good job. You have nothing to lose. You are already in a very good job.
Here also, even in the board, we'll be only trying to help you rather than harass you. We are not here to harass you. No, don't feel this thing. So always give one of the smile wherever this thing. Then see the people around, what is the reaction and all you will see. And answer question very briefly. Don't beat around the bush.
Okay, sir.
If you don't know answer, you just say I don't know.
Okay.
See, many times your voice is low or you are beating around the bush. He is asking one question and he is answering something else. See, ICSE, you can say, I don't know.
You seem to be very reluctant to say, I don't know. Because only one is don't know.
See, because I also didn't know that, the provision, not everybody need know actually that. See, whether you are as a private candidate, whether you can apply, may know, you know, you have studied ICSE.
Yes,
so if you have that knowledge, otherwise you have studied in the regular stream, so you may not be knowing that whether you are entitled or not. So when such questions come, don't try to guess something and beat around the bush. So that is not a, yes, I don't know, sir. So very politely you can say, I don't know, sir. So we make it very brief, and whatever you have written, as I already pointed out, this DAD, this I, then about your Haridwar, your Bareilly, whatever you have mentioned, lawn tennis, then sending troop to Afghanistan. He asked a very direct question. You are again beating around the bush. See, whether he is asking whether you are for it or against it. If you are for it, you must say 1, 2, 3. These are the 3 points which why I want to Indian troops to go. No means,
yes.
In this case, the country is asking me, see, when UN peacekeeping force, as a part of that, India has gone to many places. Africa, in many places it has gone. But that is as a part of our commitment to UN. We send our troops. When there are two countries, between two countries, or even if it is US mediated, we have to think twice before sending our troops. Because we are putting our troops at risk. Isn't it? So, based on our experience in IPKF in Sri Lanka, it was not really a wise decision to send IPKF. So, we were not able to solve the problem because it is an internal problem. And we lost our precious life of our soldiers. So, like this, 1, 2, 3 points for or against. You must say that. Right? Instead, you were just going around and around and around. He was trying to extract your answer from you, but still you are not giving answer.
In that case, I wanted to ask, if I would have said no and then given that answer of developmental rule, would that have been good, or should I have skipped the developmental rule altogether? What the stand of India has been so far.
So you need not go into history, background and all. When the question is asked, give a straight answer. What is expected is yes or no, he is asking. If it is yes, why? 1, 2, 3. No, why? So like that it should be. See, try to be very brief. When you beat around the bush, you will get caught. Because you will say something and another question will be asked on that. Okay. Then, but the question he asked, why Indian universities are not able to measure up to the level of international universities? Again, for and against, you can have views why it is not. What are the constraints in our Indian system? Whether our higher institutions have got full autonomy. See, the autonomous institutions like IITs are able to do excel. Whereas many other universities, they don't have autonomy. And the quality of teachers is also, say, there is no rigorous exercise to upgrade their knowledge. So these two could be, from my point of view, at least these two could be the reason. But we ought to also look into the aspect of how actually they grade these universities. What are the criteria for grading these universities? See, sometimes those grades may be relevant to us or may not be relevant to us. See, our IITs may be much better than Harvard. But how it is measured? And third point is, in many US universities, it is based on individual professor and scientists. See, if this scientist migrates to another university, then the standard of that university goes up. So it is based on individuals, professors and scientists. So that kind of system is there. So in our case, there is a lot of scope for improvement. But we have to also see on what basis these are all graded internationally. See, for instance, Oscar Award is not given to Indian movies. But what kind of standard they keep for Oscar? So just because that we have not got Oscar, we cannot say that Indian movies are bad. They are not up to that standard. They may be better off than some of the Oscar movies also. But maybe technical quality, those things they excel. And they get. So whenever internationally it comes, what kind of standards are used for measuring competence also will have to look into. So you can always give your answer justifying these are the factors. So if it is more autonomous, maybe our quality of our universities will go up. If you have a better quality of teachers, more rigorous course of selection, then they will be better off. And more exchange with the international universities, then they will be better off. Some of them importing some ideas. See, why our people are not getting Nobel Prize? That could be another question like this. See, not only quality of the... So like this, be very specific in your answer. So you must smile, you must also increase your voice, and third, you must be very specific to the answers in such a way that it impresses. And wherever you are strong, that point, you can put a leading answers so that next question will come on that. So that kind of taking, that's what I said, you are that scholarship and all. You can always. So these are the things which I think you have to improve. When is the interview?
23rd March.
23rd
March.
Next 3rd March.
23rd March.
23rd March. Because another boy said the 3rd March.
20.
So it is a...
So one month is there, you can practice these things.
See, you have got all
cheerful and proactive. So don't let
you have got a very good knowledge base and you have got good qualities and your impressive personality, everything is there. The only thing is these changes you will have to do in the next couple of weeks. Try to improve on. Write down. For all that answers, you write down in a notebook so that you don't beat around the bush.
Okay. Okay.
Sir, one thing I wanted to ask regarding how do innovative steps you look at tennis?
No, I'm just asking you, pointing you in the scratch.
Okay, sir.
Possible. You have to read a little bit about Roorkee and Bairavi also.
Okay, thank you.
All the best.